See, some of the demerits in the fixed currency system will become merit here, and some of the merits of fixed will become demerit here. First one is market determined rate. Now what happens when RBI or central bank fixes your currency, say $1 is equal to in this range rupees 60 to rupees 70, then this is not an unreasonable range, right? Because they know that your transactions are more free today and convertibility restriction is less. They fix this range on the basis of certain market factor calculation. So this is not absolutely unreasonable range. Only in uneven circumstances your price will either fall below 60 or it will go above 70. Otherwise, it usually remains in this range. So as a result of the flexible currency regime, we can say that one of the benefit is currency rate is market determined. Okay? Your currency rate under flexible system will be market determined. Does not affect monetary policy. Remember, I told in earlier point as demerits that because of fixed currency regime, in order to make sure that your currency remain at that range, that is $1 is equal to 20. So in order to maintain that it neither moves up more than 20 nor it goes less than 20, you have to continuously intervene in the exchange rate market. But when you have made a range like 60 to 70, your intervention is limited. So when your intervention as a central bank governor is limited in the exchange rate management, you can focus more on monetary policy. So your monetary policy does not get affected because of exchange rate management. Okay? Because intervention in currency market is limited. So you will only intervene in uneven situation where your price is less than 60 or more than 70. Otherwise, there is no need for RBI to intervene. So as a result of this, your monetary policy does not get affected because of exchange rate management. Another point that is related to this point is third point, monetary policy objective. Now we have seen that earlier our currency system was fixed, but now it's flexible. So there were two kind of monetary policy objective. One was multiple objective. Another was single objective. Under single objective, it means that inflation control is the only single objective. Inflation control. So this objective of following only inflation control or single objective is not possible. Not possible under fixed currency system, okay? Because under fixed, RBI will have to follow multiple objective. Has to be followed under fixed currency system. So we have seen the benefits of following single objective and multiple objective. So if RBI wants to follow single objective of inflation control, it will have to move to flexible currency system. Okay. So what is the merit of fixed flexible currency system? Merit of flexible currency system is that RBI as a central bank or as a monetary policy authority can follow single objective of inflation control. This single objective was not possible under fixed currency system. Okay. So these were some of the points. Now we will see what are the demerits in the flexible currency system. Demerits. One, it will result in speculation. What happens under flexible currency system? Under flexible, you will write full flexible currency system. I am just writing under flexible current and capital account transactions. Can be taken freely. Because there is less restriction on undertaking current and capital account transaction. Now since there is less restriction, as a result of this, more players, more people can participate in currency market. So what do you mean by more people can participate in currency market? Currency market is the place, if this is a currency market, this is a place where currencies are traded. So someone will sell dollar, someone will buy dollar, someone will sell yen, someone will buy rupee, this kind of thing. So currencies are traded. So this is called currency market. So when you are following currency market, so when you are following flexible currency system, more people can participate. As a result of this increasing in the participation, usually if you think on the reasonable sense, then only those people who have foreign currency exposure should participate in the currency market. Because suppose if you are importer, then you should participate in the currency market because you need to sell rupee and buy foreign currency. If you are an exporter, then you should participate in the foreign currency market because you will get a dollar, so you need to sell your dollar and buy rupee. But there are third category of people called speculators. So these speculators are those people who are neither importer nor exporter. They are simply bettors. So they are betting on the foreign currency. They are betting that, oh, on the basis of my observation, dollar will depreciate, or on the basis of my observation, dollar will appreciate. So these people are called speculators who have no foreign currency exposure. They are neither going to receive any foreign currency nor they have to pay. But they will simply do betting. Now what will happen, as a result of flexible currency system, more people are allowed to participate. Because of that, this speculator class are also allowed to participate in the currency market. Now what will happen, they do not have genuine foreign currency exposure. They are simply thinking it as a lottery, that they will bet whether dollar will increase or dollar will fall. As a result of their betting activity, dollar movement varies. Okay? Because earlier dollar movement would depend only upon the importer and exporter. If more importers are there, then there will be more demand for dollar. If more exporters are there, they will increase demand. Importers and exporter will increase supply. So earlier, had there been only these two player, importer and exporter, then dollar value would have depended only upon the import, upon the demand and supply of dollar. But because of speculator, this adds another uncertainty to the dollar movement. So this is one of the demerits of flexible currency system, that even if dollar should appreciate, it may depreciate because of the position that has been taken by these speculators. Okay? Then your second